So, Mr. Kaufman, because you were not here at 8:30, as I indicated, you did issue the finding, and so the officer, the witness, was released. Because of that, he is no longer here. I certainly will vacate the finding of guilty, but we will have to reschedule the trial.
I just didn't know there was a difference between, I thought there was a difference between a hearing and a trial, so I didn't know that there was, I didn't know they were the same, so.
All right, well, what we'll do is we'll give you your trial date before you leave today, and now so there's no misunderstanding, what will happen on that trial date is the state will present the officer, and you'll be able to present whatever evidence or testimony that you wish to do.
Sure.
Okay, so if you would just have a seat, the clerk will get a court date for you, we'll give you that, and then you'll be free to go until your trial.
I have another court case for, I did a mark, so I was hoping to get both of mine.
And that's a Concord case?
Yes.
I've not seen that.
Yeah.
Usually comes with this, maybe. And I don't remember seeing one, yeah. I may have seen it in a hundred cases, I don't, just not remember it.
Have you been given a court date, on that one?
Never, yeah, I just have so much paper, I don't get it all.
Well, we'll try and find it, and if it makes sense to put them together, we'll try and do that for you.
We don't have, that's what happens.
Okay.
Could be an arraignment, something, you don't have.
It's an arraignment, it'll be an arraignment, so.
Okay, so. They haven't actually filed that complaint with the court yet, so we don't have anything. If you were given the arraignment date, it would have been either on the, were you given a hand summons? Probably.
Or in person, yeah.
Right, and that would, that, they gave you that date, but we don't have it in our system. And depending on our schedule, sometimes on arraignment dates, we don't have time to do trials, but I'll make a note that we'll try and accommodate that request. Okay? All right, so if you could please have a seat. We'll give you your trial date and then you'll be free to go. If you want to wait and see when you get that up on there, you know.
It doesn't mean your felony is probably in my inbox to be open. I don't think I've seen it. Judge, if you want to move the arraignment to the trial date, I'm fine with that. I will file the day he was noticed. If you want to ask Mr. Kaufman if he's comfortable with that, and if he's comfortable with this, moving his arraignment to his new trial date, I'm fine with that.
Right, Mr. Kaufman, what we're trying to still do is figure out accommodating doing them together. What we're going to do, if you're agreeable, is instead of trying to squish in the trial on the arraignment date, which is difficult just because there's so many arraignments, we would give you a trial date and turn your arraignment into that same date. Later than probably September 2nd.
Could you even make it just the arraignment into a hearing or a trial and just like push it all forward? Because it's like almost the same thing. I feel like my rights have been violated.
Waiver arraignment.
But that's just, it's just a constitutional right thing. That's all.
We're trying to accommodate you. It's just that it's kind of awkward since we don't actually have the complaint yet.
I appreciate it. Yeah, we'll spend time to it.
What we'll do is we'll give you a trial date today on this case. As soon as we get the other case docketed,
yes,
we'll put that trial date the same as what your trial date is.
Sounds great.
Okay. All right. So just have a seat again. We'll give you your trial date and then we'll be free to go.
And I'll see if I'm able to find out. I'll file it right away. I'll remember to the court that it's going to be joined up, the arraignment is going to be joined up at the trial.
All right. Thank you.
You bet.
All rise.